You know, I'm starting to notice a trend, guys. You catch a common theme I'm seeing with the colors of all of our recent vehicles? Yeah, it's blue. Apparently, the new rule now, unknown to me, is I'm going to just keep buying blue derby cars. We got the old Volkswagen that I'm tearing apart right now. We got the new Volkswagen Jetta that we're going to derby. We got the blue Dodge Avenger. And we have a new car that we just picked up for the collection for 2022. Want to guess what it is? It's something we've ran a lot of. Boom. Yep. We got another Ford Taurus. Blue, of course, just like the others. I don't know what it is. Apparently, if it's a blue car, I'm going to buy it. That's how it's going to end up these days. Wasn't planning on buying this, to be honest. Not in the market for a lot of cars right now. We have plenty of cars to run, you know, need to clean out what we got, and got plenty of projects on this property, heaven forbid, if you guys have seen now. But sometimes things just kind of happen and you can't say no to a good offer that comes your way. So we acquired this car from a buddy of a buddy who sent info our way about this thing that came up for sale. Probably the top dollar amount that we spend for cars, but this is fully a complete driver. I mean, I can hop in it right now, go get groceries down the road, no problem, drive it around, it's going to make the trip without issue. The only thing I am aware of on this car is these struts are worn out and they clunk and they knock a bit whenever you hit bumps. Not that big a deal. Other than that, you could easily probably flip this car and put it back on the road and sell it. But I got it cheap enough. And as you can see, it's not stripped yet, so we'll see when we derby it. I don't know if it'll be this year. I don't know if it'll be next year. But you guys have maybe heard me say this before, but I'm telling you, this might be the cleanest Ford Taurus I've ever owned or laid eyes on. And that's saying a lot when you're here in the old Rust Belt of Indiana. So let me show you what I'm talking about per example of some of these cars. If you're not familiar with these Fords, there's a couple common rust spots that are notorious to rot on. First off, right by the lower A-arms rots out. That one, if you can see that, look at that black frame on this thing. It just barely got a little bitty speck right there. That is a stupid clean frame. I mean, a black front frame. And then, of course, if you're familiar with any of the Sables and Fords, normally they're missing this plastic rocker and that's just complete rot and that piece is hanging down, it's all blown out, and once that goes, the next part is the floors and it travels under the whole car and your seats fall through the floor and it just absolute mess. We've learned when we ran the Taurus wagon, the Ghostbusters wagon, we are no longer buying these things if the floors are gone, because that one almost decapitated my foot when the firewall folded all around the gas pedal. So no, not again. But this one, I made sure to get pictures before I purchased it. Check this out, guys. I don't know how well the camera's going to show this. It is pretty darn clean under here. Yeah, there you go. Look at that. All back. Very surprising to see that for this thing. And this is a higher mileage car. It's in the 180s, somewhere in there, as far as the mileage goes. Engine can use a tune-up, you know, a little rough and idle, but drives fine, doesn't stall, nothing crazy like that. Probably just needs cleaned out. A tiny bit of rust just starting, surface rust right there. That's the first start, and then it travels down there and travels all along there. So my guess is this was probably old grandma car, kept in the garage for a long time, definitely didn't see much snow, long trips driving in the weather, stuff like that. Pretty cool. Or maybe it just sat for a really long time when it was first bought and then later on was driven. Once, you know, we switched to different methods of salting our roads, we don't have as much corrosive material in Indiana as we used to. So it doesn't eat away as the cars like it was. But yeah, I'm happy with it. Pretty awesome find to send it our way. Going to be a really fun one to build and run. No idea what we'll build it for. No idea where it'll run. I think Susan's got her eyes on it. She's probably going to claim this one only because I've already got two blue cars right there and she's kind of running down on numbers of what she's going to run. Don't forget, we also have two more Fords that are complete unknown mystery vehicles at this point. We have another Ford wagon and we have the Sable. Both of them have not started or ran in years. 4 or 5 years probably is my guess. I have had them for too many years myself. They've been sitting. We need to tear into them. We need to find out if they're going to start and run. We got to figure out what's going on with them before I just let them completely fall apart. I've got them buried way back behind the horse barn back in that field there. Now I need to drag them up here. If I had indoor space to work on them, it'd be a different story. So we'll get into them this year, though. I promise you that. Somebody hold me to that. Get on me. We got to find out if we can get those things to run. If those things are junk, then we got to strip them for parts. Scraps high. We'll get them out of here. So pretty cool about this. I'm going to fire it up right now. If you notice, the window is down. It's actually sitting in my lane because I've been using this as my farm car. It came with a new battery, maybe a year old, maybe less than that, in this thing. Taurus trunks are quite large, so I've been driving this around. Right now, I've been taking it back to the horse barn. I'm emptying a lot of stuff from my pole barn back to there into storage and sorting it. There's scrap metal all over this property in these old buildings I'm just taking out that needs tossed, some heavy cast iron, things like that I don't want. So we are filling the Volkswagen full of scrap. We'll get that loaded up and be good to go on that. Before anybody asks, yes, this car is going to scrap. I was going to make a separate video on it, but there's not much to tell you. I really, really wanted to derby this car again. It looked so good to derby again. The back was doing some really crazy natural stuff, like the way it packed in and the bumper was straight. Wheels were good. We had good struts. This one was just starting to bend. Steering was good. Biggest issue, if you remember, was we had the fuel leak, which caught us on fire after the derby. I did patch that. I did get it to hold pressure, I think. I don't know how long it would have lasted long term, of course. But we did get this car to actually start up back at the old property. We were planning to drive this onto the trailer to move it to this property. I started up the car, shifted it into gear, and nothing. I had no gear, no reverse, no drive, no 1, 2, 3, any of the gears. Nothing moved, nothing tried to move. The engine was running in idle. You could hit the gas, rev it up. Fluid was all there for the transmission, had not leaked out. I don't know what happened to it. I've technically never drove this car, had it moving at any point since the derby, so maybe it burned up when the car died at the derby. The engine itself I thought was going to be junk, but it survived, wasn't knocking when it fired up. Maybe the transmission let go. Maybe that's what finally killed this thing at the end of the derby. I don't know. So we got no way to move it. If that's the case, then we strip it down, we get the parts that we can, because we got a whole nother one sitting over there, and right now scrap's high, so we're gonna get this out of here, and we got many other projects to work on. Not worth the stress of even remotely trying to put a transmission in this thing with these complicated German cars. So what you see here is probably most of what's going to the scrapyard with it. Still got to fill it full, weigh it down. Not much else to take off. Got my hoses I'm pulling from right out of the front, get our window bar, door bar. We'll get to work on the next one. Good tires, rims at least to swap out. Maybe I'll save that back bumper. I was very, very impressed with how well it held up. I'd like to maybe experiment with that and do some crazy stuff with it. So I might just unbolt that. It's pretty easy to get off. We'll get those struts out of there too, by the way. We use this car and all of these cars when we hauled them to this new property, by the way. It was wintertime, it was freezing cold, but we used all these cars as portable storage sheds to get all of our stuff here. Tools, car parts, we stuffed every car full of stuff, including this one, just to get stuff here and unload it. I need to get all those CV axles and struts out the trunk of this and back to the horse barn, which we're in the process of doing right now, get that in storage. But there you guys have it, out with the old, in with the new, one blue car gone, one blue car here. Before you go, let's fire this thing up, show you what we got under the hood. I don't even remember which version of the engine this has. So this is a good chance for me to go ahead and look, because I can't remember. Want to see if this is the 3.0, which version of the 3.0, or is it the Duratec? Duratec's commonly on those Sables. So this is the 3.0, all right. We've ran this style before. Pretty good engine. I do like it. Nothing major to worry about with the setup of this one. This one has very simplified coolant hoses compared to the Duratec, so that's awesome. That'll help us out a bit. other than that, it looks really good shape. It does have a newer remanufactured alternator, so that's nice. That's a good thing to save, you know, after we get that out of here. It has the aluminum top motor mount. We will swap that for a steel one off some of the other cars. Some of those are hit or miss. Some of these will have steel on them. I saved them. We'll swap that out. That's a main issue for derbying, of course. Coil pack's going to get moved. It looks like somebody has labeled... Can you really see that on there? I don't know if you can see that with the sun. There you go. See that? Someone has labeled those spark plugs. That tells me someone's had this off and apart. So it's either got a new coil pack or somebody put in new spark plugs relatively recently and didn't want to confuse them. Even then, if it's new spark plugs, you would only pull those boots off. You would not pull these top ones off. So I bet you this has got a relatively new, it looks pretty clean. I bet you that's a new coil pack as well. That's a really good thing to have for all these Fords, which means we know we have a good working coil pack, guys. We can take that coil pack and test the other Fords that we got in the back. If we can't get a spark and with starting spray, we can pop this one on one of them and see if we can get spark in case one of those coil packs is bad on one of those cars. So that's good to know. And of course, there's that new battery I was talking about. Trying to see if I see a year on it somewhere. Oh, I was a little off. It is a 2020, so year and a half old battery, but I'll take it. Free battery is a free battery. I need some more of these farm batteries around here just to move stuff around. So, close this back up. And I'm gonna finish moving some stuff around before the sun goes down. Catch you guys at the next video.